13. Exodus chapter 13, and then I want us to go to 1 Corinthians chapter 5, I believe it is, verse 7. But right now I want to read some verses here in Exodus. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, sanctify unto me all the firstborn, whatsoever openeth the womb among the children of Israel, both of man and of beast, it is mine. And Moses said unto the people, remember this day in which ye come out from Egypt, out of the house of bondage, for by strength of the hand of the Lord brought you out from this place. There shall no leavened bread be eaten. This day came ye out in the month Abib. And it shall be when the Lord shall bring thee into the land of the Canaanites, and the Hittites, and the Amorites, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites, which he swore unto thy fathers to give thee, a land flowing with milk and honey, that thou shalt keep this service in this month. 7 days thou shalt eat unleavened bread, and in the seventh day shall be a feast to the Lord. Unleavened bread shall be eaten 7 days, and there shall no leavened bread be seen with thee. Neither shall there be leaven seen with thee in all thy quarters. And thou shalt show the son in that day, saying, this is done because of that which the Lord did unto me when I came forth out of Egypt. And it shall be for a sign unto thee upon thine hand, and for a memorial between thine eyes, that the Lord's law may be in thy mouth. For with a strong hand hath the Lord brought thee out of Egypt. Thou shalt therefore keep this ordinance in his season from year to year. And it shall be when the Lord bring thee into the land of the Canaanites, and he swear unto thee and to thy fathers, and ye shall give it thee, thou shalt set apart unto the Lord all that openeth the matrix, and every firstlings that cometh of a beast which thou hast, the males shall be the Lord's. And every firstling of an ass thou shalt redeem with a lamb, and if thou wilt not redeem it, then thou shalt break his neck. And all the firstborn of man among thy children shall thou redeem. And it shall be when thy son asketh thee in the time to come, saying, what is this? Thou shalt say unto him, be by strength of hand the Lord brought us out of Egypt from the house of bondage. Purge out therefore the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump as ye are unleavened. For even Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Now, somehow or another, I gave you, or something happened in this transition, the wrong text. And the text should have been Exodus 12. It could have been my handwriting. I don't know what happened in the transition. But let me just read a couple of verses.
That's your teeth is too hard, only I do.
Just a couple of verses from
What is that?
Exodus chapter 12.
What it tastes like.
Just so you can see where I'm going.
Here we go.
I'm not going to read the whole text. You can read that for yourself. Exodus 12, verse 23. And reading. But Jehovah will pass through to smite the Egyptians. And when he seeth the blood upon the lintel and on the two side posts, Jehovah will pass over the door and will not suffer the destroyer to come in unto you, under your houses, to smite you. And ye shall observe this thing for an ordinance to thee and to thy sons forever. And it shall come to pass, when ye are come to the land which Jehovah will give you, according as he hath promised, that ye shall keep this service. And it shall come to pass when the children of Israel say unto you, what meaneth ye by this service? That ye shall say, it is the sacrifice of Jehovah's Passover, who passed over the houses of the children of Israel in Egypt, when he smote the Egyptians and delivered our houses, and the people bowed their head and worshiped. The text is supposed to be when God gave instruction to the children of Israel how they were to be protected when the death angel would come to the land. And he says, when the death angel comes, he's going to smite the firstborn in every family, man and beast. But wherever he saw the blood, he would pass over that house. Now the text said this was their Passover. 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7 says, Christ is our Passover. I'm going to use for a thought for this little homage. Pack it up. Getting ready to go. I'm not going to be long. Pack it up. Getting ready to go. My suspicion is that everybody in here has taken a trip at one time or another. And if you were going overnight, you packed a little night bag. If like some of us used to go to the National Convention, we packed 3 and 4 and 5 bags. We'd be gone for a week. We would pack according to our stay away from home. We'd pack our bags. And we wouldn't wait. Well, most of us wouldn't. Wait till that day that we're leaving to pack our bags. Right? Sometimes we're packing the night before, a couple of days before, so that when we got ready to go, all we had to do is reach back and grab our bags. That's what we would do. Now that's from the physical perspective. But in essence, God has told us in this text that when he comes for us, we need to be ready to go.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to need some help.
Yeah. All right.
And let me tell you why I'm going to need some additional help, because Sister Marcia used to help me every Sunday.
Yes, sir.
Matter of fact, before I finish your verse, sitting right away by where Sister Emma Mathis is, she would help me out. She'd help me preach every Sunday. But, showing up, that was her word. That was her. We're going to miss showing up. We're going to miss showing up. But the Lord has told us to be ready. For in such an hour as you think not, the Son of Man is coming. And it may not necessarily be that we'll be here for the rapture.
That's right.
If he calls us today, that's the day he's coming for us.
That's
the day. And whenever he calls, we need to be ready.
That's right.
Well, he told the children of Israel, this was the last straw. He had sent frogs, locusts, lice. Man, he had sent all kinds of curses to try to get Pharaoh to let his people go. Pharaoh would say he's going to let them go, but before the next morning he'd be changing his mind. He didn't want that free labor to go. Just like another crowd of people I know. Yeah, that's if y'all didn't know why, that's why we've been slaving all those years.
Yes, sir.
Somebody got free labor. Free labor. And Aquinas is kept. That's why America is one of the richest nations on earth. Because we worked for them for a number of years. For free. And haven't got paid yet.
Rich by
free labor. Pharaoh didn't want to give up his free labor. But God had to put one more curse on him.
One more.
Just one more.
And he said that I'm going to kill every firstborn. I'm going to smite every firstborn in the land. But here's what he told the children of Israel. That's what he told his people. He said, here's what I want y'all to do. I want you to go get a lamb.
Yeah.
Without spot or blemish. I want you to kill it. Take the blood. And put it on the doorpost. Both posts, I want you to put it on your house. And he said, when I see the blood, I will pass over. If you look at that word Passover in the Hebrew, it actually means hop over. It means hop over. So when the death angel was going through the land in the street, and when it came to a house where he saw that blood, that death angel would just hop over. It would just hop over that house. Listen, if you are a child of God, you don't have to worry about nothing. I think Paul, the outline said for the first thing, the first outline, sister. Okay. He prepares us. And he prepared the children of Israel by telling them to get a lamb and take the blood. Now you had to be obedient. Now, if you were not obedient to that, you were killed. Your firstborn was killed like everybody else. The only thing that prepared you for what was going to happen was your obedience to the Lord. But not only did he prepare his children, what's the next one, sister? He prayed. He purged them. And the way he purged them was through the blood of that lamb. Now, everybody in here that's saved have been purged. Now let me tell you, it's not because you're a primitive Baptist that you purged. It's not a Methodist or Pentecostal, cogent Methodist, a Christian Alliance, Christian Disciples, Seventh-day Adventist. None of that has anything to do with your purging. So if you're counting on your denomination to get you there, you better go reevaluate. Because the only thing that is going to prepare and purge us is the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus washes us white than snow. And everybody that's saved, you've been washed. Am I right, somebody? I'd ask you the question, have you been washed in the blood? Soul cleansing. Blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Because I've been purged. I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. Now in that text in Exodus, it says, this shall be a Passover unto you. But then that was in the Old Testament. When you come to the New Testament, he says to them, Jesus is our Passover. It is the blood, not of some lamb or goat or bull, turtle dove, but it is the very blood of Jesus that becomes our Passover. The very fruit of the vine that we will sip today around this table represents the blood. It's the blood that saved us. The blood that washes us. Did y'all know the blood is costly? The blood is, yes, literally, that's right. The blood is costly. Salvation is free, but it's not cheap. It cost Jesus his life's blood. Yes, now, let me just give you a few things about the blood. I ain't gonna hold you. But the blood is costly. And the blood is powerful. Yes, the choir just sung it this morning. Yes. The white blood cells and the red blood cells have distinct character of how they function in our bodies. Now y'all can Google it and pull it up and see. You may not find this in the Bible, but you can find truth anywhere. But the blood cleanses us every 23 seconds. Check it out. Every 23 seconds, those white blood cells are eating up the red blood cells. It eats up all of those blood cells that might have something in them that would destroy us every 23 seconds. If that were not, that, you know, when folk get cancer, that's what's happened. Those red blood cells cease to function the way they're supposed to. They all come together in what they call catastasize. I think metastasize. They come together in a group and they won't spread out. And they get lazy like some of us, just won't do our job. And when they do, our bodies end up with some kind of cancer or some disease. The blood is purged in us every that keeps us healthy. The blood of Jesus. Listen, that's why we don't have to worry. Even when we mess up, And somebody messed up last week.
Yes, sir.
Somebody messed up today.
Yes.
Somebody messed up in their thinking while they've been sitting here this morning.
Yes,
and thank God the blood shall never lose its power. Because it cleanses us. It washes us. And makes us white as snow. The blood of Jesus has washed us and has prepared us to go to heaven. That's why we praise Jesus. That's why we love Jesus. That's why we value Jesus. Because he loved us and demonstrated his love by sharing his life's blood on Calvary's cross.
Yes,
put the sword in his side and a crown of thorns on his head and spikes in his hand and feet.
Yep.
He shed all his blood.
Yes.
And sinners plunge beneath that flood, lose all their guilt and stain. And so Jesus did it for us, y'all.
Yes, he did.
And if it were not for Jesus' blood, we'd all be on our way to a devil's hell. We'd all be on our way to eternal damnation. The bulls couldn't do it. Goats couldn't do it. The best they could do was for 1 year. And they'd have to come back, go get some more bulls and goats, turtle doves, and kill them. Sister, I'll never forget this. Sister Mary Ann's, the young lady that's got the camera there, sending the message on Sunday out to the whole nation, whole world. Whole world hears this. So not just y'all, no more loose artists. The whole world hears this message.
Amen.
But her son in Sunday school, one Sunday morning, we were downstairs. Is Edward here?
He over in the corner.
Yeah, there he is. We were all just, Sister Davis might remember it. We were all down there talking about the lesson for the day. And they always ask the young person to review the lesson. And they asked Ed this Sunday to review. Here's what Ed said about the blood of bulls and goats that they were offering. Remember, they had to offer a bull or goat every year.
Amen.
They had to kill it and take the blood. Edward said, I know those animals were glad when Jesus came.
That's right. Yeah.
I never will forget that. And the truth just struck me, I had to laugh.
Yes, sir.
Those bulls and goats were so glad. When Jesus showed up, finally my Redeemer has arrived.
Yes,
but not only for them.
That's right.
For you and I.
Amen.
The Redeemer has arrived.
Yes,
and he has set us free.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
From sin and shame.
Yes,
he set us free.
Thank you.
And every man that will confess him, he will set him free.
Amen.
No man comes into this world sinless.
Amen.
David said, we're born in sin.
Amen.
And we've been shapen in iniquity. All of us come in here the same way. All have sinned. All of us. Not a one have a right to ever say, talk about somebody else. Maybe you haven't committed adultery. Maybe you haven't committed fornication. Maybe you haven't gotten drunk. Maybe you haven't done drugs. Maybe you haven't lied. But I promise you, you did something. You did something.
Yes.
And God can deliver you just like he delivered me.
Yes.
Amen.
And he can give you brand new life.
Yes.
He can set you free today.
Yes.
If you go to Christ.
Yes.
He will set you free. What's that last point, Sylvia? Is it protects. The blood protects us. When Jesus said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Wherever he saw the blood, no harm was done to that family. Don't you know that that's true today? That Satan can't do us no harm?
Yes, sir.
Well, we apply the blood of Jesus. Satan can't have the blood. Can't do nothing with it. You stay covered. There have been plenty of testimonies about the blood of Christ and how he protects us. The Bible says in Revelation that they overcame the devil by the blood. They overcame the devil by their testimony and by the blood of Jesus. Somebody would have killed you, but the blood protected you. Somebody would have shot you, but the blood protected you. I'm going to give you this last truth, and I'm going to be true. The blood saved Israel. In a historical sense. Historical sense.
Yeah.
It saved Israel long range. It saves us long range.
Amen.
Right? Without the blood, we couldn't go to heaven.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Many of us have claimed the blood to protect us, prepare us, and purge us to go to heaven. But we haven't appropriated the blood in the present day sense.
Well,
it's the blood that gives us victory every day of our life.
Yes,
not only in eternity, but in time. Amen? The blood protects us today, right now. While we're here. And some of us don't. When we say, I've got peace that cannot be explained, we got peace because of the blood.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, amen.
When the word says we are more than a conqueror through him that loved us. It's talking about the word, but the blood. When he's talking about all the blessings that we shall get through Jesus Christ, he's talking about what the blood is doing for us right now. Not going to heaven, but right now. That blood is working on our behalf. And it shall never lose. It reaches and it flows through the blood that does what gives us strength from day to day. It shall never lose its power. I thank God for the blood.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Thank God for the blood that Jesus shed on Calvary. That blood ran down the body of Jesus. It kept on running. Now y'all can claim your own area. If you say, but that blood ran down through Virginia and covered a little old disobedient boy in Stuart, Virginia.
Yes, sir.
All right.
He washed me It kept on running.
Yeah.
But before it got to Virginia,
yeah,
and before it covered me,
yeah, yeah,
it went all the way back to Adam.
Yeah.
And it kept on flowing.
Yeah.
It flowed down through all the prophets.
Yeah.
It hit Abraham.
Yeah.
Didn't it do it?
Yeah.
It hit Abraham,
yeah,
Isaac, yeah, and Jacob.
Yeah.
It came on down.
Yeah.
Ezekiel,
yeah,
Isaiah,
yeah,
Jeremiah,
yeah,
kept on flowing.
Yeah.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
Crossed over,
yeah,
New Testament.
Yeah.
Picked up John.
Yeah.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
Matthew, Mark,
yeah,
Luke, and John.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I'm so glad,
yeah,
that it rolled to where I was.
Yeah.
Any sin come before that flows, you lose all. You know what? It's still flowing.
Amen.
It's still flowing.
Amen.
If you open up and say, I want Jesus in my life,
yes,
that blood will cover you right today.
Amen.
Right now. Protect.